India is set to become the third largest economy in the world by 2030. Our Prime Minister's vision with the Make in India initiative has placed the country on the threshold of major reforms, making India one of the preferred manufacturing destinations for investors across the globe. Taking the vision of the Make in India campaign a notch higher, Tata Steel Group established an eco-friendly special economic zone in the Gopalpur region of Odisha. The project aims to create a favorable economic environment to promote industrialization in this state.
Typically in a developing country and definitely in India, if you were to go and build a, look for a site somewhere, unless you go to an industrial park or an SEZ or a domestic tariff area, etc., you would struggle because if you were to go and acquire land, it takes time, right? So an SEZ saves a lot of that time, particularly if you're a foreign investor who really is looking to find his or her way around in the country. Going to an SEZ makes it a much easier option. Tata Steel in the past, when we wanted to go set up an office in the Middle East, our first port of call was the Jebel Ali Free Trade Zone. I'm talking of something that we did almost 25 years back, right? So at that time, it was a easy place to go to and set up office, and the SEZ in some sense took care of a lot of the administrative work which you would have to run around and do yourself as a company. So the concept of an SEZ is to make it a hassle-free entry point for an investor who probably doesn't know India very well and doesn't know how to maneuver his way around.
See, one of the biggest challenge in Make in India is when the investors come, how to provide them land. And Gopalpur provides the contiguous land which has already been acquired, and people can come and subject to environment clearance, they can start building up their factory maybe within 3 months to 6 months depending upon the nature of the industry. So if Make in India is to be successful and the time is a big factor in there, then Gopalpur provides the ideal destination.
The Tata Steel SEZ is located 170 kilometers from Bhubaneswar, the state capital of Odisha. The industrial park has been designed by Subarna Jurong Private Limited and features a walk-to-work concept.
You know, in Singapore, the largest industrial park is held by Subarna Jurong, and they have done design of industrial park in, I guess, more than 10 countries in the world. And they bring in with them the expertise of the world vision. If you have foreign investors to come in, they need to see who has designed the infrastructure or who has designed the master planning of the site. So that, and they do the master planning on a 100-year vision. So that takes care of almost all kinds of, you know, situations that can arise in future. So to that account, our site provides the best site.
The strategically located Tata Steel SEZ Gopalpur offers excellent connectivity by road, air, rail and sea. Gopalpur Industrial Park is located on the National Highway 16 that connects two large metropolitan cities of India, Kolkata and Chennai. The industrial park is located 170 kilometers from Bhubaneswar International Airport and 240 kilometers from Visakhapatnam International Airport. Additionally, an operational airstrip also exists at a distance of 4 kilometers from the park. Gopalpur Industrial Park is well connected with a broad gauge rail network that connects eastern and southern parts of India. Behrampur Railway Station, one of the busiest railway stations in this region, is located at 24 kilometers from the park. Gopalpur Port, an operational port, is located just 8 kilometers from the park. Tata Steel Special Economic Zone is planning to develop a road corridor to the port and reduces the distance to 3 kilometers.
This is a new initiative of Tata's in Gopalpur, where they are coming up with a special economic zone. The advantage of this area is that it is very strategically located. It's very close to Gopalpur port, which is coming up. It has good water resources available around it. And the best advantage of this Gopalpur SEZ is that the land is completely unencumbered. The land is completely, there is a complete boundary wall there. Everything is there, power availability is there. So I think it's coming up quite well.
It's located in a very exciting space. You know, I look at, if you look at the trade, if, trade normally happens around the seas. Okay, so like somebody said, maybe 2000 years back it was the Mediterranean, then it became the Atlantic. Now it's the Pacific, but I feel increasingly the Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean are going to be two important seas around which there'll be a lot of trade. And to me, this SEZ is very, very strategically located. It's straddles the eastern and the southern part of the country. And like I said, if you start measuring distance in dollars and not in kilometers, you're closer to most of the exciting economies of Southeast Asia. And that gives you a tremendous market, because to me, between the markets available in India and those markets which border the Bay of Bengal, you're talking of servicing 2 billion people, which is about 25 to 30% of the about 30% of the population of the world. So they are so easily accessible. So to me, the strategic location is very key. And in Odisha, we have a state which is working very hard to attract industry. The state is very supportive.
To be one of the biggest steel producers worldwide, Tata Steel has set up a 55,000 tons per annum high carbon ferrochrome plant in the special economic zone at Gopalpur in Odisha. The industrial park will primarily attract investments in steel and allied industries.
We have a ferrochrome plant project which is about 55,000 tons per annum producing plant. It has got two furnaces, and this plant will cater to converting the chrome ore that we mine in Odisha and convert that to ferrochrome, and Gopalpur port being close by, we will be able to export as well as domestically we can transport within India. Our ferrochrome plant is going to start operation sometime in the month of November this year itself. And as we see, this itself will transform the place. The moment a ferrochrome plant of 55,000 tons per annum starts, it includes a lot of transportation, manufacturing, direct indirect labor coming into the plant. We have the unmanned aerial vehicle producing factory, which is going to start next month very soon, which will be supplying to defense, and that will have another kind of employment. We will be working on the higher end of technology. So I believe this will create enough of hunger among the people from outside to cooperate and get more and more industries inside.
The project of Tata Steel Special Economic Zone in Gopalpur has not only generated direct and indirect employment opportunities for the local population, but has also contributed to the overall socio-economic development of the region.
Just now we have put up a 55,000 tons per annum ferrochrome plant, very small plant, but it itself has created 150 direct jobs and more than 300 indirect jobs. And that's only occupying 300 acres out of the 3,000 acres that I'm talking about. And we have put up a small, less than 50 crores investment by a Megit Corporation of UK, who will be producing unmanned aerial vehicles. And it's over 2 acres, and they have given employment to 15 persons, and there will be indirect employment to about 30 to 35 persons. Now you can imagine, when we go for 2,970 acres, the amount of the job generated, direct, indirect together, we believe more than 15,000.
It is a part of the southern Odisha. I think, first of all, it would provide employment to people who are based in southern Odisha. That will be a great benefit to the people of South Odisha. That is one thing. Second, as the industry grows, as the units start coming up in the SEZ, it will boost the economy there.
The Tata Steel Special Economic Zone and Industrial Park in Gopalpur enjoys perfect proximity to educational, social and recreational infrastructure. That's up on the other side of the break.